The biggest names in business meeting in the Motor City to focus on American competitiveness.
And we continue our coverage of this national summit with our own Alexis Glick. She is live from Detroit, and she's joined by a very special guest with a very optimistic outlook on his company and the United States' future. Good to see you, Alexis.
Great to see you, Liz and Dave. That's absolutely right. Here is an executive that is very optimistic, and that is Steve Odlin. Of course, he is the chairman and CEO of Office Depot. He's joining me right now. Steve, good to see you.
Great to be here.
You are here focusing on some very important issues. You just got out of one of the key sessions for today. What is it right now that you want to say to people about the health of the economy and how that's affecting Office Depot?
Well, Office Depot provides office products and services to a lot of businesses, mostly small businesses. And right now, our business has been affected by the economic meltdown that really began in the fall. And I think it's really important that we return liquidity to the marketplace. You know, if you think about these small businesses, they've got under 20 employees, and you ask any small business person, how'd you start? They'll say, well, I took out a second mortgage on my house, or I took out a line of credit against my home. And this is how they finance their businesses. And right now, with the housing market creating this meltdown, they don't have sources of liquidity. So I think we need to get back with the banks and all the sources of liquidity to help these small businesses create the jobs that we need to get through this cycle.
One of the top criticisms, though, about this administration is that they're not doing enough to address small businesses. And if they do create 70% of the jobs in this country, why aren't we doing more? What do we need to do?
Well, look, all business jobs are created by small businesses. You know, large businesses create, but they also creatively destroy jobs and they get more productive. So there's a net zero job creation with big business. It all happens with small businesses. And small businesses need funding to get going. And I think every cycle is led out by the small businesses creating jobs and taking risk and innovating. And so anything that we can do from an administration perspective, from a banking perspective, from a mortgage perspective, to return liquidity to these people and help these small businesses grow will lead our economy to health.
I want to preface something by saying that this is the quiet period, so I know you cannot comment specifically on earnings, but your stock has been under severe pressure and has been one of the biggest rallying names. I mean, one of the biggest movers in the S&P 500, up 700% over the past couple of months. Can you point to some resumption in growth in the economy or some stabilization? Because a lot of people do feel that you are macroeconomically tied specifically to where this economy goes from here.
Well, because Office Depot has all of our products tied to productivity in the marketplace and employment and so forth, we are macroeconomically sensitive and we're tied to that. And I think that our stock was impacted like everybody else's stock was during this downturn. I think what we need to see is we need to see some economic help here. And that's why I'm so bullish on the small business help, because we really need to see our small business customers get going again. And we as an economy need for small business to lead us through this thing. And I think it will help everybody. You know, it's not a sector, housing is not a sector issue. It is really part of the banking issue and it's part of the economic need.
How would you describe your opinions about the economy? I mean, in a nine-inning ball game, are we just halfway through? Are we in the seventh-inning stretch? I mean, where are we in this recovery, or is the stabilization going to last a year, 2 years down the line?
Well, there seems to be consensus about it, which makes me a little nervous in and of itself. But that we're not—it's not getting worse, and that's good news. The question is it going to be like other recoveries, you know, which have been sort of a V recovery? You hit a bottom and it bounced. And, you know, my suspicion is that in those recoveries, it was small business that let us out. In this case, I think it's going to take longer. And so I think it's going to be more of a U where we continue here and work through the issues. And that's why, we think that the experts are probably right that it's going to be sometimes around the beginning of the year. But we can hurry it up if we can provide more liquidity to small business.
So nowhere near the seven inning stretch.
Well, I think it's a stretch.
It's a stretch, not the seventh inning.
I don't know how long, yeah.
All right, Steve Odlin. Terrific having you on. Thank you so much. We appreciate it.